basketball fans. This is Pete Grigsby Jr. for Intermountain Sports Network. We're coming to you live tonight, WPRG TV 5 here at Betsy Layne High School, T.W. Howard Fieldhouse. And I have with me our special guest, the coach of Shelby Valley, Jason Boer. Jason,
yeah.
Seems like you're always here near the finals and the finals of going to state. You're doing a great job over at Shelby Valley.
Well, I appreciate it. We just need to get there. And, you know, we got two big steps. Tonight's a real big step, and then tomorrow night obviously be a big step as well. But, you know, we just continue to take it one game at a time, and, you know, hopefully we continue to advance throughout the tournament.
You were in AA last year, now you're in A. How come you switched classes? Is that according to enrollment or something?
Right, in all A, they take, you know, it's got to be in the top three classes or three grades, 10th, 11th, and 12th grade. You've got to have 425 kids, I believe. Last year we had 427 in the top, so it's two kids above the cap, but of course we've fallen way under that. We've lost some enrollment this year, so of course we made the All-A pretty easy this year. But you know, it's just you know, when you're on the borderline, every year you don't know if you're going to be in it, but it looks like the next few years we'll be in the All-A.
Now tell us a little bit about yourself. You've been coaching how many years, and where did you start coaching?
Well, it seems like we started the other day, but now I add up the years, it's been 12 years. And you know, I started my coaching career out of University of Kentucky after I graduated from Kentucky at Corbin. In Corbin High School, I went there a couple years. Then I went to Henry County as a head coach 1 year, and then back to my alma mater at North Hardin for a couple years. And then I landed back in Eastern Kentucky, you know, at Shelby Valley and Belfry. So, you know, I've been in the coaching, you know, ranks 12 years, I guess, now, and this makes my 6th year as a head coach. And, you know, every team is always special, but this is another good group of kids that I've enjoyed being around, and we have a lot of fun together, spend a lot of time together.
Okay, now you started being a head coach at Belfry, wasn't it?
Yes, that's right.
Tell us about your Belfry experience.
Well, you know, over at Belfry, we had some hard-nosed kids, and, you know, they played extremely hard, and, you know, they were coming off a pretty bad season before I took the job. And, you know, I think we ended up winning 11 games that year, and then Randy Casey got the job after that, which was my assistant over there, and he's done a great job ever since. You know, it seems like ever since I left Belfry, we've always had to beat them in the region tournament. And luckily, we've been able to do that the last 3 years that I've been at Shelby Valley. So, you know, I don't know if we'll run into Belfry again. It looks like history tells us we will. But, you know, Belfry will always be a special place just simply because that's where, you know, that was my second head coaching job. And, you know, it was a great experience over there that year.
Now, tell us about your Shelby Valley coaching career. I know you haven't been there very long, but you've been highly successful. Tell us about that.
Well, any coach will tell you, you know, that tells the truth is if you got good players, you got an opportunity to win each and every night. And if you don't have good players, it's hard to win. But, you know, we've been fortunate at Shelby Valley to have really good basketball players and good minds and, you know, heads on their shoulders and so forth. So, you know, as long as we're, you know, as long as we got some good kids that always buy into the team concept, hopefully we'll continue to be successful.
Well, you've done a great job there at Shelby Valley, and I know you'll continue to be successful. You have a great young bunch of boys coming along, and good luck to you. I'm going to join you in the circle here. Who's going to be the head referee here? Here, you want me to interview you? This is Mr. Bell. Get a camera close in there. He wanted me to interview him tonight. How you doing?
Great. How you doing?
Okay. You
ready for a good game?
Yeah. All right. Who's going to give who's giving the word here?
You going to listen to this speech?
Yeah, I want. Hey, get him on here. Let's see what. I always want to know what goes on in the inner sanctum down here.
All right, here we go.
Kentucky High School Athletic Association tells us we got to talk about sportsmanship. This is your only warning concerning taunting and baiting. You won't get another one. All right, coaches, are both teams legally and properly equipped? You're free to stay or you may go. What we got here? White? Who's going to do talking? Number 11, White, captain here. 32 is my captain here. White, you must have a white T-shirt on only. If you're going to change it, you change it in the locker room. Don't change it out here on the floor. You're in blue, you have a blue T-shirt only. If you're going to change it, change it in the dressing room. You got Roger Fairchild, Mike Hall, and Mike Walker working with you tonight. You guys play hard, stop on the whistle, and we won't have any problems. Roger, you got anything to add? Mike, you got anything? Have a good game, guys.
Hey, thank you, Mike. Good job, boy. Always wondered what went on those little huddles. They didn't have when I coached. Might have helped the slow bark.
Hey, Pete, how are you?
What was that deal? Said you could leave if you wanted to, and just talking to the captain?
Yeah,
Yeah, they give us the option after a couple minutes of listening to that. We pretty much know the routine, so we don't really have to hang around that much.
Well, it's pretty well the same thing every game, isn't it?
Yeah, they do a good job. Those guys, especially tonight, those three are good officials, and they'll call a good game.
They've called a good tournament so far, really. And, well, you've played this team before. You lost by 15 not too long ago. Tell us a little bit about what you might do tonight or what you expect from them.
Well, you know, they're not going to change a whole lot, and we really can't either. They're a solid team. They shoot it well. They pass it well. They got six or eight kids that have great basketball knowledge. They create matchup problems for us. Although we have a 6'9 or a 6'10 kid in the middle, they create problems for us because they're hard to guard man-to-man. We like to play man-to-man, but they all shoot it so well, and they're all such good slashers to the basket, and they all pass so well. It makes it a difficult matchup for us when we like to play our man-to-man defense. So we might mix a few things up tonight, throw some zones at them, throw some traps at them, and just see. They're the type of team, you know, if they're hitting, their shots, there's not a whole lot you can do with them. But hopefully we'll come out and get a few breaks early and hang around for a while.
What about the tempo? Will you try to control the tempo?
We'll have to try to control the tempo, but they do a good job of making sure you don't. They're always trapping and always making you play fast, and hopefully we'll shoot it well and get some buckets off our turnovers and hopefully play well tonight.
Well, Barnett, whatever it means, we rank you, Ken Hall and I out there, rank you in the top five in the region, and, you know, you can compete with these guys at Paintsville and Shelby Valley. Your team's come a long way, and we certainly appreciate the effort your team and you have put into this season.
Well, we got a good group of kids here. We play really hard. We practice really hard. And, you know, we feel like when it's all said and done here in a month or so that we'll be right in the thick of things. You know, we come out of a really tough district, but we feel like we're going to get better down the stretch here, and hopefully we'll be one of the teams here in March fighting for a chance at Rupp Arena.
Thank you, Bart. Congratulations on the season, and good luck the rest of you.
Thank you, Coach.
There's Bart Williams of Pikeville. We've been fortunate to have the interviews, two head coaches, plus what the referees do in that huddle. You know, Ken, I always wondered what they were saying and doing. Now I know. We didn't have that in my day at McDowell, and didn't have it in your day over at Virgie. But anyway, old sidekick up there in the booth, and Wayne Fugit, take it away, partners.
Thank you there, Pete. And we're just a few minutes away from the start of this first semifinal game tonight. It'll be Shelby Valley and Pikeville, followed by South Floyd taking on the Paintsville Tigers. So be sure and stay tuned. Live high school basketball right here on the Intermountain Sports Network tonight. Glad you joined us, and we'll send it back to the station and be back in just a couple of minutes with more pregame activities on Eastern Kentucky Sports Leader, the Intermountain Sports Network.
It's a brand new year, and you're on your way to right where you want to be.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
Can you believe your dad's still out there? He's loving it. Everything okay?
Yep, everybody's back.
Wherever life takes you, Apple Action Wireless is there, keeping you close until you're together again. You always get more with Apple Action Wireless.
What are people saying about Pikeville College? Pikeville College is about the students.
We have a small lab setting, so you really get to know the students and interact very well with the students.
I know every student's name. When a student asks me for help, I know who they are.
And the professors want you to succeed. Anytime you need help, all you have to do is stop by their office.
The professors are always available. They're there for you.
Pikeville College is changing our world, one graduate at a time. We would like to include you.
Johnson Industries' Unisampler is a coal auger sampling system developed and manufactured by Johnson Industries. The Unisampler is a unique sampling system that will allow the operator to extract coal from trucks, rail cars, and river barges in as little as 30 seconds. No conveyor belts or shaker tables are required. No carousel is needed, and only one operator is required for the system. The Unisampler is being utilized by two of the largest coal laboratories in the world, Johnson Industries. Products developed by miners for miners.
Everyone's talking about it.
Wow.
Unbelievable. The best thing since cable.
Intermountain Cable saves you a bundle with four great services on one easy monthly statement.
That's fantastic.
Digital cable, high-speed internet, digital phone, and home security for one very low monthly price. Intermountain Cable gives you all the entertainment and security your home needs.
Wow, sign me up. I love it.
You guys are the best.
Carly Perkins Job Corps Center offers vocational training or military preparedness for those between the ages of 16 through 24. Trades offered include CNA, masonry, HVAC, hotel clerk, facility maintenance, electricity, along with these.
I'm being trained at the Carly Perkins Job Corps Center to be a carpenter.
I'm being trained in culinary arts at Carly Perkins Job Corps.
I'm working on my MOUS certification in business technology at Job Corps.
I'm preparing for a military career in Job Corps.
Job Corps, where success lasts a lifetime.
Introducing home security at your fingertips from a name you can trust. Microtech is now offering home security in your area. Microtech's state-of-the-art monitoring provides the peace of mind that comes with knowing your family is safe. And whether you're across town or out of state, your home is always protected when you're away. Right now, sign up for Microtech monitoring service and receive 1 month free with free installation. Call Microtech today.
And welcome back to Betsy Layne High School. This is Ken Hall along with Pete Grigsby Jr. and Wayne Fugit as we're here for semifinal action in the All-A 15th Region Classic. And it'll be Shelby Valley and Pikeville here in the opener, a 59th district matchup. And Pete, you had a good interviews out there with both coaches. And this should be an interesting ball game. These two teams played last Friday night at Shelby Valley. Shelby Valley winning by 15. But this is a whole new night, whole new atmosphere, a big ball game here.
Oh, yes, it's going to be a good ball game. And you could tell by the interview with Bart Williams, you know, his team is coming along and they're going to get stronger. And I think he has some kind of strategy for this game with Shelby Valley. But he realizes that Shelby Valley is the top team, probably in the 15th region, in our estimation anyway, and one of the better teams in the state. And one of the things that impressed me was I got in that huddle down there with, Mike, what's his last name? The old there, the referee.
Mike
over
Walker.
Huh?
Mike Walker.
Yeah, Mike Walker, Mike Hall, and the other guy. I thought they was going to hang a whistle on me before I got out of there.
Oh, okay. Not do you good to get out there and run up down the court for a game, Pete.
I'm telling you, it'd be an experience, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
I gave you guys up here in the booth something to talk about.
We have, in my opinion, we'd have a lot to talk about. And we're ready now for the national anthem.
Thank you.
starting lineup.
The Wildcats of Shelby Valley.
Pete, another good crowd here tonight. We've had had good crowds every night at this tournament.
Did you have a pretty good crowd last night?
Yes, we did. Had an excellent crowd.
I watched the rerun of that game. And it seems like you had a good game in the sense that, Allen Central scored a lot of points, but Paintsville, they just outmanned them and outscored them.
Well,
Sloan was really great.
Landon Sloan was just amazing, 36 points. Allen Central got off to such a slow start. They got themselves in a hole. They made some great runs in that second half, but they just were so far down they couldn't pull back. So we got the starting lineups here for Shelby Valley. Number 3, Elisha Justice. Number 32, Jacob Bryant. Number 20, Jonah Justice. Number 10, Logan Bryant. And number 12, Ashley Hatfield, rounds out the Shelby Valley starting lineup. Now the Pikeville Panthers will be introduced.
And now, for the home team on the score, the Panthers of Pikeville High School, with a record of 10 wins and 6 losses. Starting at guard, the 5'10" sophomore, number 15, Gatlin.
Number 15, Gatlin Clark, starting for Pikeville.
Starting at guard, 5'8" senior, number 3.
Number 3, Jordan Bell.
Starting back off, 6'1" junior, number 11, Matt.
Number 11, Matt Clevenger.
Starting back forward, 6'2" senior, number 2, Tim Honaker.
Tim Honaker wearing number 2, and rounding out the starting lineup for Pikeville, 6'10", Devin Adams. Wearing number 23. And like Pete said, we've got Mike Walker, Mike Hall, and Roger Fairchild, three really fine officials out here calling this game.
They've been doing a fantastic job throughout this tournament, too, Ken. Both teams, there'll be another team coming in the nightcap.
Good to see Mike Hall out there. We don't. Right now, Shelby Valley or Pikeville, neither one got any halls out there playing, so at least we've got one officiating.
Well, if I can just keep the Bryants and the Justices and the Hall straight, I'll do a good job tonight. I've done my homework today. I think I can keep them straight most of the time, I tell you, just so we don't run in any more halls off that bench.
Okay. Yes, we're ready to go. Ashley Hatfield will jump against Devin Adams, and here with your play-by-play, Pete Grigsby.
Mike Walker stepping in, ready to toss that basketball up. And we start the first game of the semifinal contest, 15th region all-way tournament. And there's the tap. Goes to the backcourt to Pikeville, to Honaker. He gives it to Clevenger, a little playmaker. Gets it across to Bell. Do you see Bell want to be interviewed tonight?
Yeah,
he want to be ran up to. He want to be interviewed. Uh-huh. Here's Pikeville on the attack, 2-3 zone. By the Wildcats as they move it around top of key. Clevenger has it. Clark for 3. Missing. High rebound goes to Hatfield. Shelby Valley. And there's Jonah Justice. Jonah in the lane. Pulls up. Gets to Hatfield. He's cut off by Adams. In the corner back to Jonah for 3. Air ball. No good. Bell, but this guy on the floor rebounds it. Streaks down the court, top of key over to Clark in the corner. Back outside to Bell. Clark is just swinging back for the high post. It goes. Clevenger's in the high post now. Low post to Adams. Adams tries to shoot. Well guarded. Passes outside and a long two-pointer. No good, but Clevenger. Rebound to Shelby Valley. Here comes the Wildcats. In the corner to Bryant. Bryant fakes, drives the baseline, cut off. Elisha Justice, top of the key, through his leg dribble, gives it over to Jonah. Jonah Justice into the lane, cut off, in the corner to Jacob Bryant again. He's playing both corners, Ken. Jacob is.
Yes.
Against that man-to-man defense. Here's Eliza Justice, pull up jumper, left of the key, 15 footer, good. Two
nice
to nothing.
Shot. He got a good pick there from Jonah, I believe it was, his brother, Jonah Justice, and nailed the jumper.
Here's Pikeville on backcourt, just passing ball back and forth. Clemenger on the right side, goes down into the corner to Adams. Back outside the fence, stolen by Justice. Eliza all the way up and 2 points. Nice steal. Good defense by Eliza Justice.
Well, I tell you, he's got another steal.
Absolutely. You blink your eyes, he's got it again. There's Jonah on a miss, driving to the hoop. We got a whistle and, what is that, a charge?
They got Jonah over the back going for the rebound. Okay. He missed the shot, tried to follow it up. First foul of the game for either team.
Here's Pikeville, full court, has to face a 2-2-1 zone, the one that they use so effectively. Shelby Valley Wildcats, full court. They just kind of make you work a ball right now. Trap you at the midcourt. In the corner it goes to Honaker. Back outside to Clark. Clark swings it over to Bale. Bale drives, cut off, goes to the corner. Back outside it goes. Bale has it in the corner for three, missing. Rebound goes to Hatfield. Shelby Valley has it. Back to Logan Bryant, who moves across midstripe. Into Hatfield, he loses. Picks up by Jacob. Long three, top of the key, no good. But Logan Bryant, rebound by Honaker. Here come the Panthers. In front court, double team on that team. There's Bale driving the baseline, loses it. Picks it up, gives it to Clark. Top of key, Honaker fakes. Drives into the lane. There's collision and between him and Hatfield. And what's the call?
They're going to get Hatfield for the block. I think he was a little late getting over there and not in position to draw the charge. So that's his first, team's second.
4-0, 4:54 to play in the first quarter. Clevenger inbounds at the front court to Honaker. Outside it goes. They move around to Clark on the left wing. In the corner, back to Clevenger. 2-3 zone for the Wildcats as Pikeville just testing the zone out. And they're moving into the lane. Clark misses an 18-footer, and rebound is knocked out of bounds by Jacob Bryant. It's back to Pikeville. Pikeville's not hit a basket yet. They had several shots.
Had some good looks, but unable to get anything to fall so far.
Pass into Adams on out of bounds, and he banks it in from about 8 feet from the side.
Pretty shot there by Devin Adams.
On the other end, he blocks the shot, driving to the hoop with Jacob Bryant, and Adams made a terrific block, knocked it out of bounds.
He
sort of like Al Lean used to do.
Nice block.
Here's Shelby Valley. Hatfield gives it to Justice. Justice loses the ball, tapped out the Bale. Bale streaks down the court, misses layup, but we got a whistle on the rebound that Bale missed. Referee Fairchild saw a push in there, Ken.
Devin Adams got the foul. His first, team's first. Devin Burchett in now for Pikeville, wearing number 4. He replaces Bale.
Little left-hander, isn't he? He hit a couple threes the other night in the first game. Here's Lyson Justice. Cross the midstripe, takes the screen, goes to the right, drives by Adam, puts it up, misses. A rare miss for Eliza, rebound by Honaker. Low scoring game so far. Neither team's really heating up the shooting so far, but they'll probably catch it a little later. 2-3 zone for the Wildcats. There's Clevenger penetrating in the lane, puts it up and scores.
Good soft touch by Matt Clevenger.
Quickly down court to Jacob Bryant on the answer, and as he drove the basket, we got a foul out on the floor. Mike Hall called that one.
There's Devin Adams again. That's two on the big guy. Second team foul on Pikeville.
Here's Hatfield underneath his own basket. Throws it out to Logan Justice. Inside the Hatfield turns around. 14-footer rolls off at the last minute. Rebounded by Jonah Justice to Jacob Bryant on the baseline. Another block shot by Adams. What we got? What kind of call we got there?
I think he called a charge on Bryant as he ran into Honaker.
Yeah, Here's Clevenger in backcourt. Throws it into Clark. He gets it back to Clevenger. On the right side it goes to Burchett, who's in the game for Pikeville. Here's Clark driving. In the corner it goes to Honaker. Back outside. Inside high post to Clevenger. Clevenger moving into that high post from his position. Here's Honaker faking. Driving baseline, kind of a scoop shot, back over his head. What's the call?
He stepped out of bounds, stepped on the baseline on the drive. So, turnover to Shelby Valley. Tyler Newsom in the game now for Shelby Valley, number 24, replacing Jonah Justice.
He's the son of assistant coach, isn't he,
Greg
Tyler?
Newsom, right.
Had a good game the other night,
by
the way.
Oh, he sure did. Double figures. I think he had 11 points. Played really well. Had a couple of nice blocks, too.
Pikeville in the 1-2-2 zone. In the corner it goes to Hatfield. They double-team in the corner. Slices on the left wing. Back to Hatfield. He's double-teamed. Ball goes to the floor. Almost loses it. Saves it. Throws it across the way at the 24. Tyler Newsom just came into the game, and he banks in a beautiful shot from the right of the key.
Beautiful job using the glass there.
Clevenger breaking the pressure. Moves it across.
Tyler
in the game. Baker's in the game. He misses a runner on the baseline, rebounded by Jacob Bryant. Here's Hatfield in front court. His team leading 6-4, 2:15 to play. There's Hatfield, long three from the corner, no good. Rebound by Newsom, back up and in.
Boy, Newsom, four quick points here to put Shelby Valley up 8-4.
Shelby Valley just staying in that little pressure defense. That's all it is. They don't trap out of it. Just make you work the ball a little bit. Pikeville does. They answer getting it across. Back out to Clevenger. High post to Honaker. Over it goes to Burchett on the left wing. He misses. Rebound by Jacob Bryant.
And he threw it away. Trying to go long to Kirby Tackett and just out of his reach.
How many turnovers that make so far?
That's two for Shelby Valley, and Pikeville's got three. Shelby Valley dominating the boards, though, lead 8-3 they've out-rebounded Pikeville.
Here's Bell back into the game. The little fellow passes it over to Burchett. In the middle of Clevenger, down that goes to his teammate Baker, back outside. They work against that zone. The zone shift's pretty good for Shelby Valley. They play it pretty tight. And they cover the penetrations. Clevenger's the only guy that seems to be able to penetrate. He has the ball. Over to Burchett, right wing. Back there he goes. He penetrates. Gets it back outside. He was cut off that time. Good defense by the Wildcats. They move it around out top. And the left side it goes. They're very cautious, very patient with the basketball. Pikeville working for that good shot. Shelby Valley setting back in that zone defense, 2-1-2 zone. They shift really well in it. And there's a bad pass deflected by Shelby Valley into the hands of Newsom, and he gives it over to Elisha Justice. They killed a lot of clock that time.
Well, they did.
They're very patient on offense. There's Justice to Jacob Bryant. Elisha drives, cut off by, he has Bale on him. A lot of speed by Bale. Played terrific regional tournament last year, I thought.
Ken. Oh, he did. He was tremendous.
17 seconds to go. There's a pass down the sideline to Elisha Justice, and Mike Walker calls what?
Knocked out of bounds by Jordan Bell there. 16 seconds left in the first quarter. Shelby Valley leads it 8-4.
Here's Bell on Justice. 11 seconds. Clock running. 1-4 offense. Middle is open. Elisha gets it in the corner to Newsom for three. No good. Rebounded by Baker. Long, long heave. Way down court. Way off range. At the end of the buzzer. Low scoring first quarter for these two ball clubs. They played about a week and a half ago. 15-point win by Shelby Valley. It's 8-4. Shelby Valley on top of Pikeville. We'll be back in just a few minutes for the second quarter of the semifinal contest. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
It's a brand new year. You're on your way to right where you want to be.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
Can you believe your dad's still out there? He's loving it. Everything okay?
Yep, everybody's back.
Wherever life takes you, Apple Action Wireless is there, keeping you close until you're together again. You always get more with Apple Action Wireless.
What are people saying about Pikeville College? Pikeville College is about the students.
We have a small lab setting, so you really get to know the students and interact very well with the students.
I know every student's name. When a student asks me for help, I know who they are.
And the professors want you to succeed. Anytime you need help, all you have to do is stop by their office.
The professors are always available. They're there for you.
Pikeville College is changing our world, one graduate at a time. We would like to include you.
And welcome back to Betsy Layne High School. We've completed one quarter in tonight's opening game. 8-4, Shelby Valley leading Pikeville. And it'll be Shelby Valley ball to start the second quarter. Pete, very low scoring quarter there, but let's see if these teams can get it going here in this second quarter offensively.
Good defense by both teams. However, like you said, low scoring. Inside it goes Logan Justice on the corner of Hatfield, misses shot from. He got a pass from, we got a rebound and a traveling call by Mike Hall.
Tyler Baker lost his footing as he came down with a rebound and fell to the floor and called for walking.
Here's Jacob Bryant underneath his own basket, looking. Inside wide open, he finds Hatfield and he just puts it up on the glass for an easy two.
Easy one.
Don't know how he got wide open, but he did. 10-4 now. Shelby Valley on top of Pikeville. Bell in front court out near midstripe gives it over to Burchett, who's in the game. Back to Bell, top of key. Baker, right wing, tries to drive, cut off, throws it away inside. Turnover for Pikeville, picked up by the Wildcats. Here comes Jacob Bryant, and he's called for traveling. Jacob tried to put on a spin move with that dribble, and they didn't quite catch up with the dribble. Here's Clevenger, inbounds it to Burchett.
Devin Adams back in the game for Pikeville. He's got two fouls.
Inside to Clevenger, high post, underneath the Adams. Nice high post, low post pass, and Adams was fouled. He didn't get the hoop.
Ashley Hatfield picks up the foul. That'll be his second, team's fourth.
Here's Adams, first of two, misses.
Kirby Tackett comes in, replaces Hatfield, as Hatfield with two early fouls here. He and Devin Adams, the Pikeville, each with two now.
Second toss by Adams is in for a 10-5 lead, 7 minutes to play in the second quarter. First semifinal contest of the All-A Boys, 14th regional, or 15th regional. Absolutely. Well, I get in the 14th anyway. Long three attempt. Beautiful shot from a right wing by
Logan Bryant.
Logan.
Beautiful shot. 13-5, Shelby Valley now.
Pikeville working in the backcourt, gives it to Bale. Bale in the corner. Passes it in to Adams. He's double teamed, triple teamed. He still spins and puts it in. What a move.
Great, strong move there by Adams. Beautiful turnaround.
Three Wildcats on him when they got the ball the first time. Here's Logan Bryant with the ball. Zone defense by Ben employed by Pikeville. Outside it goes. Justice over to Elijah. He misses a rare miss the whole basket. Clevenger down deep to Bell. Over to Hotacre. Hotacre puts it up and rolls it in. Now that was good move of the basketball by Pikeville.
It sure was.
Here's Elisha out front, top of key. In the corner it goes.
Yeah, he was pushed. It's going to be a foul on Hallnaker, I believe.
13-9. Pikeville within four. Clark back in for Burchett for Pikeville.
That was Hallnaker's first foul. Only the third team foul on Pikeville.
Here's a wild catch. Eliza Justin with the basketball. High post to Jacob Bryant. Jacob's double team. Drives to the hoop to the right side. Works his way in for a layup. He just kept working, didn't he?
Yes,
going
he
to that
did.
Basket.
Good, strong move in there by Bryant.
Pike going back court, facing that 2-2-1 zone defense. They trap sometime at half court. Not this time. Here's Clevenger. Find the seam, going through the lane, puts it up. No good. Rebound by Bryant. Eliza Justice with the basketball. A little point guard. Done a great job the last 2 years as a starter. Eighth grader and a freshman. Logan Bryant on the left wing. Eliza Justice into Jacob. Now he's at the high post. Double team. Bill almost steals it, but doesn't. Wildcats working. Over to Jonah Justice. Eliza looking over that defense. Into the lane he goes, challenging as he gives it up on the left side to Logan. No good. Rebound by Jacob Bryant. Jacob has it in the lane. Gives it in the corner over here to Jonah Justice for three.
The three by Jonah Justice.
18-9. 9-point lead for the Wildcats. Here's Clark in front court on the left wing. Gives it to Clevenger's going into the high post now, Ken. Back to Clevenger on the left wing. Low block, it goes to Ant. Back to Clevenger. He drives through the lane, gives it up to Bell on the right side. Bell streaks in, gives Honaker in the corner for three, air ball. Man, I've seen two or three air balls tonight.
Yes,
unusual.
We have.
On those long attempts. Logan Bryant to Jonah Justice. Every one of them. There's Jonah out front for three. Missy, you just hit a three. Adams high for a rebound, and we got a timeout on the floor by Coach Bart Wins. And we got a 30-second timeout, Ken. Give us your analysis so far of what's happening in this game. 9-point lead for Shelby Valley.
Well, the best I can tell, it's 18-9, Shelby Valley. That's my analysis. No, it's
come on out, Ken.
Both teams playing a zone and playing it really well. That's one reason for the low scoring here. Both teams really playing some good defense, making it tough to get a good look. Not been a whole lot of shots put up in the second quarter because they're taking their time and trying to find a good shot. And
Pikeville hasn't put up many threes, have they?
No.
They're driving through the lane by Clevenger, or we're trying to hit Adams in the low block, whereas Shelby Valley is working the ball for any good shot, outside or inside.
Right, whatever they can find. But Pikeville may have to start putting up some of those outside shots, or like I said, if they can get the ball into Adams, he's playing well out there. He's got 5 of the 9 points and came up with a couple of really strong rebounds here. So let's see if they can get the ball inside to Adams.
Back to action now. There's a little conversation going on with Mike Walker and Bart Williams. Mike's borrowing a towel.
Moisture on the floor here, right?
No, when I ask you to analyze something, I want you to be like Larry Conley.
Yeah.
You know, you can analyze the game. You do all the time. You just give me a hard time, partner.
I'm giving you a hard time, right. Best I can tell, it's 18 to 9. We got to have a little fun every now and then.
I know.
We do have a lot of fun
with this. At the same time, give you a very serious report of the game and keep you up with the ball game. We want you to stay tuned and know what's happening out there.
Yeah.
And we do our best to let you know what's going on. Here's Honaker throwing inbounds to Bell. He goes, Honaker goes to the middle now. They got a 2-1-2 alignment against that press. And Honaker fumbles the pass inside, receives it, retrieves it, and puts it in. How did he come up with that fumble of his?
He is really quick.
Very quick. Here's Jonah Justice in the lane, and a pull-up Jay. Beautiful shot.
Good quick release there.
20-11. Back-to-back baskets by each team. One answering the call. Here's that pressure half court now. Bell goes to the right side. High post to Honaker. Clevenger penetrates. Over the corner goes to Bell for three. And he buries it.
Beautiful shot. Jordan Bell.
I believe, is that their first three of the game?
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. Well, Wildcats have had three or four, I think. But anyway, that's the first one for Pikeville was Eliza Justice. They got to clear out, and it goes to Jonah. You know, I think Jonah's improved tremendously since last year.
Oh, he's quite a player.
He's become a scorer, hasn't he?
Yeah. In fact, I think he was MVP of the regional last year, Pete, if you remember. He stepped
Jonah
up,
was?
Made big shots at clutch times in those games.
Well, I tell you, he's picking up where he left off, I'll tell you that much. He's had a terrific tournament.
Tell you what, he's a great football player, too, and that don't surprise you. looking at him. He's
looking inside the Jonah out of bounds from Jacob, and he lays it in. Somebody went to sleep for Pikeville, but boy, it cost you when Jonah gets the basketball. 22-14, 2:41 to play in the first half. First round action semifinal contest here. There's a steal by Eliza. Drives all the way to the left and misses, a rare miss. Rebound inside by Newsom, and Newsom misses once, twice, and then puts it in. What a follow-up by Newsom.
Well, it was. He really stayed with it.
Clark's in the game for Paco. Inside it goes to Honaker. He's double-teamed. Left-hander puts it in, and he is fouled. Nice move by Honaker. You know, the other night, Honaker scored a lot of points in that high post and that low post.
Oh, he did. He had a great game. He's a fine player.
Well, Pikeville comes right back and tries to answer with a three-point play by Honaker, a senior. Played about 3 or 4 years for Pikeville. I can't recall him. And he buries it, making a three-point play, 24-17. Pikeville still hanging around. Down court, quickly it goes. Newsom, and the ball slapped out of his hand.
What a play by Bale.
And inside on a fast break from Clark. Was that Honaker on the basket?
Honaker again.
How many points did he get there in that flurry?
He got five right there in about 10 seconds. He's got 9 points in this second quarter. We still got 2:02 to play. Now, what happened here? I thought there was a timeout. Teams went to the bench.
I don't know what that was, but maybe the referees stopped the game momentarily. It's 1:59 to play in the second quarter, 24-19. Pikeville still hanging around within five. Here's Eliza Justice for three, missing, and Adams with the rebound for Pikeville. Here comes the Panthers. Clevenger driving into the lane. Pull up Jay, 8-footer good. Pikeville's hot. They're coming back now on the Wildcats. And with that, we've got a 30-second timeout as Pikeville has changed the momentum and taken it away from the Wildcats because Shelby Valley's missed some easy shots, Ken.
Well, they have. Pikeville playing really aggressive here, going to the board strong, and Honaker really taking it in strong. Clevenger just hit a big shot, and quite a game here, 24-21 now. Pikeville back with them three. They've been down by as many as 11, so good run here for the Panthers.
And Eliza's missed more shots than I've ever seen him miss in all the years he's played.
he don't miss many.
He sure doesn't, but anyway, a couple of nice follows there by Newsom, you know, trailing in there and Jonah Justice. 24-21. Honaker, since they've been moving him inside with Adams, has really given that zone problems. They're double-teaming that zone in the middle, as they should, and that's why they've been effective. They opened up the outside. Bell hit a three, and then he went the inside. So outside-inside game you have to have in basketball.
Logan,
here's the Wildcats.
Logan Bryant back in for Shelby Valley.
Logan gives it over to Eliza. Eliza driving on Clevenger. Inside pass goes to the floor. That's Newsom saving the ball. Pikeville very aggressive on their man-to-man defense right now. There's a screen for Eliza. In the corner to Logan Bryant. Drives, cut off. Good defense by Clark. Pikeville playing tough defense right now. Here's Eliza. Double team gets it outside to Logan Bryant. Logan top of key. Over to Eliza, Justice. And in the corner, we've got a call. Bell made a terrific play, but I couldn't see the whole play from here, Ken. You may did, but what was the call on it?
They called a turnover on Shelby Valley, but I think Bell had all arm on that one. He got by with one there.
Wayne, I guess you got that up there for camera. I couldn't see from this crowd. So, anyway, it's Pikeville basketball with 49 seconds to play. Down by three, and certainly will play for the last shot. I believe Bart Williams will. And there's a push off. Logan pushes Clevenger out in midcourt. And that's, you know, everybody in the field house saw that one. I don't know what the foul was for. Oh, I know what it is. They haven't gotten to the bonus yet, and they don't want Pikeville to run the clock. But that's what Pikeville will probably do here. Honaker. Into Clevenger. Clevenger comes outside now. Very versatile basketball player. He can penetrate, break down the defense. I think he's a good floor leader. Here's Clevenger outside facing that zone defense. 30 seconds to go in the half. Cross court to Bell. Back outside to Clevenger looking for Adams inside on a low block. guarded inside of attack it now on that zone defense.
That's William owning the last shot, I think.
There's a throwaway by Bell, but saved by Clark. Clark driving, goes up and under and scores. The strategy was successful. Here's 4 seconds. Liza Justice in front court to Newsom. Newsom puts up a desperation three in the corner. It's no good at the buzzer. And we come to the surprising end of the first half. Pikeville making a strong comeback in the second quarter, 24-23 in favor of Shelby Valley. So don't go away. Looks like we got a good old-fashioned barn burner here tonight on Live TV 5. We'll take the station and be back at halftime for stats, comments, this exciting basketball game. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
It's a brand new year, and you're on your way to right where you want to be.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
Can you believe your dad's still out there? He's loving it. Everything okay?
Yep, everybody's back.
Wherever life takes you, Apple Action Wireless is there, keeping you close until you're together again. You always get more with Apple Action Wireless.
What are people saying about Pikeville College? Pikeville College is about the students.
We have a small lab setting, so you really get to know the students and interact very well with the students.
I know every student's name. When a student asks me for help, I know who they are.
And the professors want you to succeed. Anytime you need help, all you have to do is stop by their office.
The professors are always available. They're there for you.
Pikeville College is changing our world, one graduate at a time. We would like to include you.
Johnson Industries Unisampler is a coal auger sampling system developed and manufactured by Johnson Industries. The Unisampler is a unique sampling system that will allow the operator to extract coal from trucks, rail cars, and river barges in as little as 30 seconds. No conveyor belts or shaker tables are required. No carousel is needed, and only one operator is required for the system. The Unisampler is being utilized by two of the largest coal laboratories in the world, Johnson Industries. Products developed by miners for miners.
Everyone's talking about it.
Wow.
Unbelievable. The best thing since cable.
Intermountain Cable saves you a bundle with four great services on one easy monthly statement.
That's fantastic.
Digital cable, high-speed internet, digital phone, and home security for one very low monthly price. Intermountain Cable gives you all the entertainment and security your home needs.
Wow, sign me up. I love it.
You guys are the best.
Carly Perkins Job Corps Center offers vocational training or military preparedness for those between the ages of 16 through 24. Trades offered include CNA, masonry, HVAC, hotel clerk, facility maintenance, electricity, along with these.
I'm being trained at the Carl D. Perkins Job Corps Center to be a carpenter.
I'm being trained in culinary arts at Carl D. Perkins Job Corps.
I'm working on my MOUS certification in business technology at Job Corps.
I'm preparing for a military career in Job Corps.
Job Corps, where success lasts a lifetime.
Introducing home security at your fingertips from a name you can trust. Microtech is now offering home security in your area. Microtech's state-of-the-art monitoring provides the peace of mind that comes with knowing your family is safe. And whether you're across town or out of state, your home is always protected when you're away. Right now, sign up for Microtech monitoring service and receive 1 month free with free installation. Call Microtech today.
It's a brand new year, and you're on your way to right where you want to be.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
Can you believe your dad's still out there? He's loving it. Everything okay?
Yep, everybody's back.
Wherever life takes you, Apple Action Wireless is there, keeping you close until you're together again. You always get more with Apple Action Wireless.
What are people saying about Pikeville College? Pikeville College is about the students.
We have a small lab setting, so you really get to know the students and interact very well with the students.
I know every student's name. When a student asks me for help, I know who they are.
And the professors want you to succeed. Anytime you need help, all you have to do is stop by their office.
The professors are always available. They're there for you.
Pikeville College is changing our world, one graduate at a time. We would like to include you.
Johnson Industries Unisampler is a coal auger sampling system developed and manufactured by Johnson Industries. The Unisampler is a unique sampling system that will allow the operator to extract coal from trucks, rail cars, and river barges in as little as 30 seconds. No conveyor belts or shaker tables are required. No carousel is needed, and only one operator is required for the system. The Unisampler is being utilized by two of the largest coal laboratories in the world, Johnson Industries. Products developed by miners for miners.
Everyone's talking about it.
Wow.
Unbelievable. The best thing since cable.
Intermountain Cable saves you a bundle with four great services on one easy monthly statement.
That's fantastic.
Digital cable, high-speed internet, digital phone, and home security for one very low monthly price. Intermountain Cable gives you all the entertainment and security your home needs.
Wow, sign me up. I love it.
You guys are the best.
Carly Perkins Job Corps Center offers vocational training or military preparedness for those between the ages of 16 through 24. Trades offered include CNA, masonry, HVAC, hotel clerk, facility maintenance, electricity, along with these.
I'm being trained at the Carl D. Perkins Job Corps Center to be a carpenter.
I'm being trained in culinary arts at Carl D. Perkins Job Corps.
I'm working on my MOUS certification in business technology at Job Corps.
I'm preparing for a military career in Job Corps.
Job Corps, where success lasts a lifetime.
It's a brand new year, and you're on your way to right where you want to be.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
Can you believe your dad's still out there? He's loving it. Everything okay?
Yep, everybody's back.
Wherever life takes you, Appalachian Wireless is there, keeping you close until you're together again. You always get more with Appalachian Wireless.
What are people saying about Pikeville College? Pikeville College is about the students.
We have a small lab setting, so you really get to know the students and interact very well with the students.
I know every student's name. When a student asks me for help, I know who they are.
And the professors want you to succeed. Anytime you need help, all you have to do is stop by their office.
The professors are always available. They're there for you.
Pikeville College is changing our world, one graduate at a time. We would like to include you.
Johnson Industries Unisampler is a coal auger sampling system developed and manufactured by Johnson Industries. The Unisampler is a unique sampling system that will allow the operator to extract coal from trucks, rail cars, and river barges in as little as 30 seconds. No conveyor belts or shaker tables are required. No carousel is needed, and only one operator is required for the system. The Unisampler is being utilized by two of the largest coal laboratories in the world, Johnson Industries. Products developed by miners for miners.
Everyone's talking about it.
Wow.
Unbelievable. The best thing since cable.
Intermountain Cable saves you a bundle with four great services on one easy monthly statement.
That's fantastic.
Digital cable, high-speed internet, digital phone, and home security for one very low monthly price. Intermountain Cable gives you all the entertainment and security your home needs.
Wow, sign me up. I love it.
You guys are the best.
And we're back at Betsy Layne High School. It's halftime of the opening semifinal game in the 15th Regional All-A Classic. The Shelby Valley Wildcats leading Pikeville 24-23. Very low scoring, but entertaining first half as both teams really getting after it defensively.
They certainly did, Ken. And Pikeville, you got to admire them from that comeback. Everything went right for them when they put Honaker in at a high post, double-teaming that zone. Adams on the low block, double-teaming that middle man in that zone. Opened up the perimeter, and they shot it and made the three, and they drove to the basket baseline. So I'm sure Shelby Valley's Coach Brewer will tighten that defense up a little bit this half.
And we'll run down the first half numbers for you. First of all, individual scoring for Pikeville. They were led by Tim Honaker with 9 points, and all of those coming in the second quarter. He really turned it on. Matt Clemser finished the half with 4. Devin Adams had 5. 2 points for Gatlin Clark and 3 for Jordan Bell, as he hit the only three-pointer of the half for Pikeville. For Shelby Valley, they were led in scoring by Jonah Justice with 7, and Tyler Newsom with 6. Jonah got all 7 of his points in the second quarter. 4 points for Elisha Justice, 3 for Logan Bryan as he hit a three-pointer, and 2 points for Ashley Hatfield and 2 for Jacob Bryant. Rebounding, Shelby Valley out-rebounded Pikeville 13-8, and turnovers ended up pretty well even. Pikeville 6 and Shelby Valley 5. So we're ready to get this second half underway, as it'll be Pikeville ball to start the second half, and they trail by only 1, so quite a ball game here. The winner will advance to the championship game tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. We'll be live right here on Channel 5, and they'll take on the winner of our second game tonight, South Floyd and Paintsville. So be sure and stay tuned for that right after this one, folks. Pete, looks like Mike Walker's ready. Are you ready?
Yes, sir. Mike said he was ready to start the game, and he's done a good job. Here's Pikeville's ball. Honaker gets it to Clark, and Clark, is that, yeah, that's Clark. The little guy hits a 2 or 3. I didn't catch it.
It was a 3.
3.
Pikeville's first lead of the night.
Here's Hatfield, jumper from the foul line, wide open. And they tie it up, 26 all. Boy, quick baskets for both teams.
Both teams.
And you hit one of the key things of the basketball game by any team, and that's no turnovers hardly. That was really
right.
Good, taking care of the ball. There's Clevenger driving, pull up Jay on the left side. Rebound knocked outside to Hatfield, and Hatfield gives it to Logan Bryant. So after that miss, it's Shelby Valley's ball in front court. Man-to-man for Pikeville. Jonah Justice for 3. Boy, you can't let him get a good look like that.
He's a great shooter. He's in double figures now with 10. He's hit 2 threes tonight.
And a football player, too. Huh?
Oh, a great football player. He's had a great season.
Here's Pikeville in front court taking care of that basketball. Both teams doing an excellent job of that. I just hope the Wildcats can do that tomorrow against South Carolina.
Absolutely.
I'm telling you. Here's Clark, top of the key for 3, and Eatler knocks it down. That's the second one of the half.
Gatlin Clark, only a sophomore.
Elisha Justice, top of the key, driving clear out, goes up and under and misses, and Adams on a rebound. Big guy got another rebound. Here's Clevenger driving, cut off, in the corner goes to Bell, back out to Honaker. Way across it goes to Clark. Clark's got a hot hand. They'll try to get it to him, no doubt, against that zone. Probably swinging around to the right and then back to the left. Clevenger's missing Clark. Back to the right. Now they hit Clark. He's too deep. High post pass inside to Adams. He loses it. Good steal inside by Jacob Bryant. Down court quickly by the Wildcats. Logan Bryant, top of key. Hatfield pull-up jumper with favorite spot at the foul line.
Nice shot there by Hatfield. Good high arching shot, and we've got a timeout Pikeville, 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. Shelby Valley back on top now, 31-29, and, well, this turned out to be a good one, Pete.
It certainly is, and you know what I think is to happen here is both teams, they come out of the dressing room fired up, and the reason is Shelby Valley, after Pikeville pulls up close to them, Coach Brewer said, we got to get on the ball, guys. Let's make things happen. Let's speed up the tempo a little bit. And Pikeville's hungry, and they got the tempo going for them. So we both speeded up their tempo, and that's why we got such a good game going here.
Exciting game now. It sure is.
5:46 to play in the third quarter. Shelby Valley on top by 2. That pull-up jumper by Hatfield, his favorite spot. Both teams demonstrating good shooting, Ken.
Yes, they are. Both teams started out really cold shooting at the beginning of the game, but they're lighting it up here in the third quarter.
Here's Bell walking across the mid-stripe. Man-to-man defense now. Coach Brewer changed his defense from the zone to man-to-man. Pikeville works it around top of the key. Over goes to Bell on the left wing. Back to Honaker. He's at the point now. He just plays everywhere. Goes into the high post. gives it up to Clem, just tries to get set for a pass. It has to pull outside because Jonah Justice made him go out with that pressure defense. Here's Honaker in the corner to Bale, and he loses it. Eliza strips him, saves it, and going down the far sideline, we've got some kind of call. There's two or three players.
Jordan Bale committed the foul there. Please. That'll be his second.
Mike Hall, Mike Walker, and Fairchild, referee. Here's Jonah driving the baseline, gets underneath the Hatfield. Boy, and he just lays it in. He drew the defense over on him and left Hatfield open, gave him a nice dish.
He sure did. Nice assist.
4-point lead for the Wildcats. They've gone man-to-man now, more tenaciously on defense than they were in that zone. Here's Clevenger, gets it over to Clark. Clark has two threes here in the early third quarter. He's being well guarded by Logan Bryant now. Inside to Clevenger, turns around in the low post. And on the rebound, missed shot, there's Adams. Big guy puts it up and in.
Nice follow-up by Devin Adams.
Eliza Justice, top of the key on the pick and roll, gets to Jacob Bryant. Jacob throws into Hatfield. Hatfield turns around, misses an easy one. He hurried that a little bit. He had the size on Clevenger to that side. Just heard his shot there, Ken. Here's Pikeville, Clevenger, setting up a stack offense. Two on each side of the lane, popping out on the left side is Bale. Goes to the three-point line, puts up three and nails it.
Jordan Bale, a big bucket. That's his second three of the night. And Pikeville back on top, 34-33.
Lysa Justice gets by his man, drives to the left of key for a pull-up jumper. In and out, no good. Jacob Bryant serves from follow, puts it up and in over top of Adams. Jacob, Johnny on the spot that time on that rebound and put back. Clevenger for Pikeville in front court. They set up the stack offense. Clark got lost. Now they got him over in the stack. Now he runs around behind the screen. Bale pops out to the left side. Now they go to a 1-3-1 offense. Over it goes to Bale. Coach Williams is directing this offense from the sideline. He's telling where to go right now. He's setting it up. Here's Honaker on the right wing, guarded by Jonah Justice. Cut off on the drive. Gives it back outside to Clark. Well, Pikeville's not in a hurry to take a shot, are they?
No, they're not. Being very patient.
They want to work their set plays in their offense. Here's Honaker, pick and roll. Back to the big guy, Adams, and driving to the hoop, we've got a block called. Adams missed the layup. Big guy was moving so fast. I don't think he's used to moving that fast through the hoop,
well,
but he was really going.
He did a nice job on the pick and roll, and Jacob Bryant picks up the foul. His second.
2:49 to play, Ken, in the third quarter.
Adams at the line for two. He's one out of two tonight.
First one up, and it's nothing but net. Tying it up again. We've got another tie, folks. 35 all. Second one on the way. It rolls off. Rebounded by Hatfield. Tight.
No good by Jonah Justice. Rebound Jacob Bryant. That's a Logan Bryant.
And Logan has the ball in the corner to Jonah Justice for two. No good. Ball tapped up. Rebounded inside, but almost thrown away. Saved inside by Bryant. And we got the ball thrown back outside.
Shelby Valley gets a timeout here. It's a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it right here. 2:21 to go in the third. It's all tied up, 35-35. And boy, I tell you, Pete, both teams really getting after it out here. What a ball game here in the All-A tournament.
What a game, boy. Pikeville making a game out of this after losing by 15. They're coming back looking pretty strong. You know, you and I have talked about Pikeville outside of Shelby Valley and Paintsville. We thought Pikeville might come in third in our estimation in the region.
Right. They've got a fine ball club. I tell you, Bart Williams has done a really good job with this team since taking over year or two ago there. He's doing a fine job.
And And we have to include the Allen Central boys team somewhere in that top five.
Right.
Johnny Martin's come back with another good basketball team.
Oh, he sure has. Got some really fine players over there this year.
Back to action now. It's Eliza Justice moving across the midstripe. Man-to-man defense for the Panthers. There's Clark on Justice. Inside the low block, it goes to Hatfield, but we got a whistle on the low block.
Matt Clevenger gets his first foul.
2:11 play, third quarter, all tied up. Throwing it away inbound, Jacob Bryant intercepts, but Clevenger driving all the way up and scores. Man, what a surprise. Jacob was surprised on inbounds pass.
Hatfield turned his back. Bryant's throwing it into him, but he turned to go the other way. Hatfield did. So.
Clevenger said, "Look what I got." He got an easy one. Here's Jacob inside the shot blocked by Adams out the bail. 2-on-1 break. The Hotmaker lays it up and in.
Great fast break by the Panthers, and they're up by four now, 39-35.
Boy, Pikeville's got that momentum going again. There's Jonah Justice for three. He misses. Long rebound goes to Clevenger. I'm sure Coach Brewer doesn't want that kind of shot, even though he was open right now. They need to get a good score. An easy basket, but they didn't work it long enough. Here's Pikeville's Honaker on the right wing. Well guarded by Jonah Justice. Clark, top of key, off the screen. Clevenger tries to throw it inside. We got a whistle away from the ball. Adams
going against Jonah Justice. He and Bell ended up over there in a collision. Bell goes down, and we got three substitutions for Shelby Valley. Tyler Newsom, Kirby Tackett, and Cody Varney in the ball game.
Varney's back in the game, 21. Here's Pikeville to Clark, and, well, Varney gets in the game and commits a foul. I believe that was Varney.
Oh, yeah, it was. Yeah.
Nobody near of a bonus as yet. Only three team fouls on Shelby Valley and two on Pikeville. Well, it's Pikeville's ball in front court again. Shelby Valley goes back to, it looks like a zone defense right now. We'll see. Yes, it is. 2-3 zone. On the far side is Clark, way out near the sideline, faking Varney. He's not in a hurry, Ken. He's driving to the hoop, gives it over to Clevenger. Clevenger penetrates in the corner and goes to Bell. Bell drives baseline, throws it way outside the Clevenger. They got some speedy little ball handlers in there now. Here's Clevenger to Bell. Left wing for three. No good. Short. Rebound fought for. Adams and Jonah Justice. No, that's 42. Tackett going for it.
Jump ball. Possession goes to Shelby Valley with 28 seconds left in the quarter.
That looked like Billy Ball there, you know.
Yeah, buddy.
I'm telling you, both of them going after that basketball hard. Hard play. Billy Ball back at UK. Here comes the Wildcats. Rice Justice, this team down to four, minute and a half to go.
10 seconds to go in the quarter.
And there it is, high pass lost. Out to Clark, down to Bell. Bell streaks under, and shot is blocked by Rice Justice, and here we go. At the Bell. At the old buzzer, into the third quarter, 39-35. Pikeville surprisingly on top of the Shelby Valley's Wildcat. We're going to take you to the station and bring you back for the exciting conclusion. Fourth quarter action here at the All-A Tournament, 15th Regional Tournament at Betsy Layne High School. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
It's a brand new year, and you're on your way to right where you want to be.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
Can you believe your dad's still out there? He's loving it. Everything okay?
Yep, everybody's back.
Wherever life takes you, Appalachian Wireless is there, keeping you close until you're together again. You always get more with Appalachian Wireless.
Finally, I've created a way to watch hit movies at home with complete control.
You're mad.
It's not madness. It's movies on demand. Just go to the on-screen guide with your remote and choose from hundreds of titles.
Ah, honey, come on!
Start your movie whenever you desire. Even pause, rewind, or fast forward without a VCR. Movies on demand. Not evil, just genius.
And welcome back to the All-A Classic here at Betsy Layne High School. We've completed three quarters of play, and Pikeville leading Shelby Valley 39-35. The winner will advance to tomorrow night's championship game to take on the winner of their next game coming up between Paintsville and South Floyd. It'll be Pikeville ball to start the fourth quarter. They've got the lead, so take it away, Pete.
Thanks, Ken. We want to thank Brent Rose and the coaches and principal school for letting us bring the semifinals and finals to you live here on Channel 5.
Absolutely. We really appreciate it.
Here's Clevenger, top of key, guarded by Elijah. Over it goes to Clark. Clark started the half with two straight threes. Gave him some momentum. Here's Adams. The little guard streaks out front. Tries to drive cut off. Back to Clark. They got some speed in there with these guys. Clark, Adams, Clevenger. Here's Clark. Now, they're just running their offense. That's what they're doing. Coach Williams said, now, let's work it, boys, and get a good shot. Here's Clevenger driving. He likes to penetrate, puts it up. Shot was blocked by Hatfield. Saved in bounds by Newsom. And here comes Justice with the basketball. Low block it goes. Tack it. Long three outside. No good. Rebounded by Pikeville. Here comes Pikeville on the attack. Bell pulls up for three and buries it from the right wing.
Jordan Bell having a huge game. He's hit three victory pointers and made several key defensive plays.
2-3 zone now for Pikeville, changing their defense. Double team on the low block. Tackett. Tackett slips underneath to Bryant.
And block by Adams. It's a jump ball.
Jump ball or a foul?
Tell the jump ball. It'll be Chevy Valley's possession.
All right. Good defense by the big guy. He just covered the sky on
yes,
Jake.
Yes, he did.
Here's Hatfield underneath his own basket. Swings way out near midcourt to Elijah Justice. Goes back to Jacob on the right side. They move it around over here to the left side. Newsom moving the ball around, trying to find that over. There's Hatfield. Challenges the big guy, and he does. A runner, an off-balance runner, and he put it over top of Adams, Ken.
What a shot.
Great shot. 42-37. Here's Clevenger in front court. Over it goes to Clark. Conacher pops out top of key. Clevenger hits the baseline to Clark. They're looking for Adams inside. But he's a little high. They're going to get him at the low block. Clevenger driving the left side of the ring. Loses it. Newsom. Two-on-one break. Newsom. There's a collision. And no basket. No basket.
A blocking foul.
Good call by Mike Walker. Boy, these referees have really done a good job. And we got Johnny Webb and company coming up the second game.
Right. We got to have Webb. We we like to apologize to the fans out there. We did a game last night without Johnny Webb officiating, and that's not happened much this year. So
no. Losing the ball. Losing. Picked up by Bell on the break. Clark missing layup from Bell. Rebound by Eliza Justice. Going the other direction now to Jacob. Bryant. In the corner, back to Jacob, who got a block shot or a foul or whatever.
Got a foul. Devin Adams gets his third. Jacob Bryant will be at the line shooting two.
42-37, 5-point lead for the Panthers. Here's Jacob's first toss. No good. Too strong off the back iron. Logan Bryant back into the game for Shelby Valley, replacing Newsom. Second toss by Jacob, and he almost missed that one.
In and all the way out, and then rolled back in.
Like a magnet on that goal, wasn't it? Wouldn't let it go off.
Wouldn't let it get away.
Full court pressure, throwing it away. Intercepted by Logan, drives the baseline, stolen by Clevenger out of his hand. 1-on-1 break, Clevenger goes to the hoop, and he's blocked. The shot is blocked by Hatfield. Beautiful defense. But I don't know what we got on the shot. Did we get a foul or what?
Elisha Justice picked up the foul.
But that crowd stands up in front of us. You can't see from here.
No,
but
you can't.
I don't blame them for getting excited.
Yeah, this is an exciting game. Matt Clevenger shooting two.
Clevenger puts up the first one. It's there. Now, when Clevenger gets that open court, he really goes to that hoop. I like the way he penetrates. I like to see those guards go helter-skelter to that basket. Second one is missing, rebounded by Hatfield, Shelby Valley. Gives it over to Jonah Justice, and he brings it across, gives it to his brother, Elijah. Is that right?
That's right.
Elijah Justice, high post. Jacob in the corner, Hatfield drives the baseline. Gives it out to Jonah Justice. He drives with the left hand. Body's all over the floor, but he missed a shot, and the rebound's fought for. Knocked out of the hands of Adams by Jacob Bryant. It's back to Pikeville. 5-14. Man, I can feel the adrenaline flowing all the way up here. It must be flowing to those ball players.
It must be. It's quite a game. Those teams really, really playing hard.
Full court pressure by the Wildcats. 1-2-1-1. Honaker throws it inbounds.
5-second count.
Yes, sir. Good defense by the Wildcats. And we've got a boy on the floor, Pikeville. Is that Bale?
Bale, I believe.
He might have turned his ankle on the end of that court. You know, there's a drop-off about an inch or two.
Huh.
He must be all right. Long three from the left side. No good by Elisha. They have to toss in to Jacob. Still 5-point lead with 5 minutes to play. Here comes Clevenger driving by Elisha Justice. Gives it over to Bell. Back to Clevenger, top of the key. And we've got a timeout on the court. Coach Bart Williams said, I want to get my team together just a little bit. And we'll take it to the station and be back for further action. Only 5 minutes to play in this exciting basketball game. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
People saying about Pikeville College, Pikeville College is about the students.
We have a small lab setting, so you really get to know the students and interact very well with the students.
I know every student's name. When a student asks me for help, I know who they are.
And the professors want you to succeed. Anytime you need help, all you have to do is stop by their office.
The professors are always available. They're there for you.
Pikeville College is changing our world, one graduate at a time. We would like to include you.
Johnson Industries Unisampler is a coal auger sampling system developed and manufactured by Johnson Industries. The Unisampler is a unique sampling system that will allow the operator to extract coal from trucks, rail cars, and river barges in as little as 30 seconds. No conveyor belts or shaker tables are required. No carousel is needed, and only one operator is required for the system. The Unisampler is being utilized by two of the largest coal laboratories in the world, Johnson Industries. Products developed by miners.
Remaining in the ball game, it's 43-38. Pikeville leading Shelby Valley. And the winner to advance to the championship game tomorrow night in the 15th Regional All-A Classic.
Here's Honaker inbounds to Clevenger. He's double-teamed over to Burgess in the game. Into Adams at the low block. He's triple-teamed. Somehow he gets out of there and puts it up and in. What a move by the big guy, the 6'9 Adams.
Great job by Devin Adams. Fouled by Hatfield, I believe.
Pikeville keeping Adams in that low post in there, Ken, and using his size because Shelby Valley, they don't have anybody too close to his height.
I don't know.
And he completes the three-point play, 46-38, surprising eight-point lead for the Panthers. In the corner to Hatfield. Outside to Justice, Elisha Justice, Jacob Bryant in the high post, over to Jonah Justice, Logan Bryant drives in, throws it underneath to Hatfield, and it's a turnover by Shelby Valley. Hatfield couldn't handle the pass.
Good pass, nice bounce pass there by Logan Bryant. Hatfield, I think he kind of took his eye off the ball and went back to get it. He couldn't hold on to it.
Clevenger double teamed in the corner to Honaker, Honaker to Clevenger. Clevenger drives through two guys in front court to Bell. Bell drives under, scoops it up with the left hand. What a shot he missed. The little fellow missed that. Elisha Justice
great
with
effort.
The board. It was a great move by the little guy. Here's Panthers, Wildcats. Eliza Justice, right wing, is open and missing. Rebound fought for, and there goes Honaker.
And he's fouled by Jacob Bryant, and Honaker down. Looks like he may have taken a shot to the eye there.
Boy, I tell you, you got to give both those guys credit. They were really going after that basketball.
Yes, they are.
What tenacity.
That's
the
third on Bryant. Honaker going to stay in the game there.
That's the kind of basketball Billy G wants the Cats to play, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Clevenger breaks the pressure, and he's fouled on the far side. It looks like Barney.
Cody.
Mike Walker keeps watching him.
Cody Barney picks up his second.
Uh-oh. What's happening? Walker keeps watching Barney.
That was 17 fouls on the Wildcats, so that puts Pikeville in the bonus.
Pikeville didn't think it was, but now the referees alertly call the seventh foul. Bonus coming up for Clevenger, who was handling the ball on the far sideline. 4:05 to play, 8-point lead. Boy, Shelby Valley's been stuck on that 38 a little while, haven't they?
Oh, they have. They've only scored 3 points in this fourth quarter. Really
struggling. Clevenger's good. Now he gets the bonus. It's two if you can and one if you can't. And he's got the can, the bonus. Put into the game many years ago, which I think is a good rule.
Yes.
Second one rolls off. Rebounded by Honecker. He loses it to Hatfield. Hatfield comes out of there and crowded. Throwing away is Lysa Justice. 2-on-1 break. Honecker, left-hand layup from Bell. What a streak and what a good passing of basketball. Alert defense by Pikeville. 49-38. Here's Wildcats. Throw it inside to Jacob. Over in the corner to Newsom, who's in the game. Long three by Eliza. He finally makes one deep in the left wing, about 5 feet behind the three-point arc, and he nails it in the full timeout. With that, we'll take a timeout and take you to the station. 49-41, Pikeville. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
Finally, I've created a way to watch hit movies at home with complete control.
You're mad.
It's not madness. It's Movies on Demand. Just go to the on-screen guide with your remote and choose from hundreds of titles. Start your movie whenever you desire. Even pause, rewind, or fast forward without a VCR. Movies on Demand. Not evil, just genius.
Everyone's talking about it.
Wow.
Unbelievable. The best thing since cable.
Intermountain Cable saves you a bundle with 4 great services on 1 easy monthly statement.
That's fantastic.
Digital cable, high-speed internet, digital phone, and home security for 1 very low monthly price. Intermountain Cable gives you all the entertainment and security your home needs.
Wow, sign me up. I love it.
You guys are the best.
Back here at Betsy Layne High School, 49-41, the Pikeville Panthers leading Shelby Valley with only 3:34 to play in the ball game. As Panthers trying to advance to the championship game here in the 15th Region All-A Classic.
Here's Pikeville breaking the pressure to former Clark. Loses ball, goes to four. He saves it, double team. Gives it to Honaker. Honaker back to Clark. Clark throws a half lob inside to Adams. Alley hooped it in. For two, off the glass, the big guy. What a play.
Absolutely.
Here's Jacob Bryant, high post. Jonah Justice for three, and he nails it. Boy, you can't let that guy get open.
No, you can.
Deadly shot tonight. Back on backcourt with the 7-point lead. 3 minutes exactly to play. Full court pressure, Clevenger breaking it. Front court, goes to right wing. He takes the three, missing. Long rebound to Jacob Bryant. Gives it up to Eliza Justice. Justice in the left corner to Logan Bryant, who's back in again. There's Joan almost open on the right side. 2-3 zone now employed by Pikeville. There's Jonah Justice for three from the right side. No good. Rebound by Clevenger. Well, I really like this Clemenger. He's an all-around player. Double teamed in the corner here. Bart Williams said, I got to have a timeout. They double teamed the little guy, and he had nowhere to go, but they called it a full timeout. 51-44, Pike on top of Shelby Valley. We'll be back for 2:25 to play in the fourth quarter. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
It's a brand new year, and you're on your way to right where you want to be.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
Can you believe your dad's still out there? He's loving it. Everything okay?
Yeah, everybody's back.
Wherever life takes you, Appalachian Wireless is there, keeping you close until you're together again. You always get more with Appalachian Wireless.
Carly Perkins Job Corps Center offers vocational training or military preparedness for those between the ages of 16 through 24. Trades offered include CNA, masonry, HVAC, hotel clerk, facility maintenance, electricity, along with these.
I'm being trained at the Carly Perkins Job Corps Center to be a carpenter.
I'm being trained in culinary arts at Carly Perkins Job Corps.
I'm working on my MOUS certification in business technology at Job Corps.
I'm preparing for a military career in Job Corps.
Job Corps, where the kids last a life.
Back here at Betsy Layne High School, Ken Hall along with Pete Grigsby. It's 51-44 Pikeville with only 2:25 to play in the ball game, and the Panthers with possession.
It's Bell giving it up to Clevenger in backcourt. Clevenger guarded by Logan Bright, moves it across on Logan. Dribbles around outside, left hand, now right hand, breaking the 5 seconds. Oh, wait, we got Mike Walker talking with Bart Williams. I don't know what happened.
I think we got a, let's see, a timeout.
Well, let's keep it here and talk about what happened there.
I think Bart thought they were about to get a five-second count and wanted a timeout and then changed his mind, maybe. No, I didn't want the timeout, but that's all I could figure that happened there. But he got it, though.
Well, what's your observation so far? We got 2:12 to play in this game.
It's been a great effort here by the Panthers to come back. They were down early. They trailed, of course, a very low-scoring first quarter, 8-4. And Shelby Valley pulled away there a little bit in that second quarter. Looked like they might go on a run there and get a big lead, but the partner just wouldn't let up. Came back strong, and boy, I tell you, Devin Adams has been tremendous inside. He's got 13 points and several rebounds, blocked shots, made some huge plays here. In this fourth quarter. Gavin Clark, that was a tremendous assist on the alley-oop in there a while ago to Adams. And been a fine ball game. Jordan Bell's made several big defensive plays, and then he's hit 3 three-pointers for 9 points, key shots. He's played well. Like I said, Clevenger's played well. Tim Honaker always consistent, so effort out here tonight by the Panthers.
Everybody's
really struggled with their shooting.
And stolen by Logan Bryant backcourt. Technical.
He threw it off the backcourt.
Logan got called for the foul on the attempted steal, and he threw the ball really hard against the backboard. One of the referees caught it, so that's going to be a bonus, and looks like a double technical on the ball possession for Pikeville with 2:06 to play. That's what I think it'll be.
And Pete, this building is packed right now.
Completely
full. All the way around.
Well, I think we're correct so far. Clevenger goes to the foul line for the bonus. I guess. They gave the signal, both the fingers up one.
And then they'll shoot the technicals and get possession back. So this could be huge.
Well, all right. He made the first. Now he gets the bonus. 52-44, 2:06 to play. 53-44.
Yeah, let's see who's going to shoot the technicals.
Well, looks like Clevenger should, I think. He's made 2 out of 2.
Right, he's had 6 in this fourth quarter. He's hit 4 out of 6.
Here's a technical on Logan Bryan. He gets 2, and he makes 3 out of 3. They will also get possession of the basketball with 2:06 to play. That makes it a 10-point lead. Very costly technical. And there is another 4-for-4 for Clevenger. He calmly sinks all four of them, 55-44. Pikeville with the basketball. Honaker trying to get his crowd up over there. Throws inbounds to Bell. Bell with Logan Bryant streaks across the midstripe. And he loses the ball. Liza Justice with it. Goes up and under and scores. 55-46. Bell inbounds it to Clevenger.
And it's out of bounds off Clevenger, they say. So another turnover partner back to Shelby Valley.
You got to take care of the basketball on all levels, NBA, college, high school, grade school. Bell's coming out, and Birch is going in. Here's Shelby Valley in front court with the ball. High lob inside the Hatfield. He puts it up and scores.
Got the bucket and the foul. Big play there by Ashley Hatfield.
Bell coming back in for Burchett. Hatfield's played a really good inside game tonight.
He's got about 12 points on the night.
And there's the attempt for three-point play, and he nails it. 55-49, all of that six-point lead. Clevenger breaking the press, gives it to Adams. Adams goes up for the shot. He is fouled by Hatfield, apparently.
Ashley Hatfield, that'll be his fourth. And Devin Adams will go to the line to shoot two.
1:36 to play. Adams at the foul line for two. Up with the first one, too strong. These foul shots down the stretch, Ken, we said before, are crucial.
Yes, they are.
You got to make them. Second one is too strong, too. Hatfield with the board for Shelby Valley. Gives it to Eliza Justice. Down back to Hatfield. Drives under, puts it up on the run. Air ball, no good. Ball tapped out to Clark. Pikeville with the ball now. Clevenger, the heady point guard. He plays everywhere, but he plays point guard really well. Fakes, tries to drive, comes back on Logan. On Jacob Bryant outside. Double team in the corner to Clark. Clark finally gets rid of it. In the corner it goes. We can't see who had the ball. I think it's, they got it back to Clevenger. And there's contact and a foul.
That's going to be all for Ashley Hatfield. That's his fifth. Yeah, that's going to put Matt Clevenger on the line to shoot 2 feet as it's now the double bonus.
He just made 4 out of 4. But since we've told everybody that, he probably missed one or two of these.
Yeah, we might have jinxed him there.
We might put the jinx on him.
He's shot 8 free throws here in the fourth quarter and hit 6 of them. He's got 12 points on the night. Logan Bryant will come back in and replace Hatfield. Only 1:03 to play. Pikeville up by 6.
First attempt is good.
5 in a row for Matt Clevenger.
That was a little flat, but it went in. Didn't have the arch the others had. He steadies for the second toss. There's the arch, and it's perfect. 57-49. 8-point lead now for the Panthers. Here comes Shelby Valley. Eliza Justice on the move. Across the midstripe. Top of the key. Long 3-shot. No good. Rebounded by Clevenger. Long pass out of the back to Burchett. Burchett to Honaker. He moves under. Left hand misses it. Rebounded by Jonah. Out to Logan. Logan's moving. He throws away. Gets the loose ball. Puts it in. Good pass. Good play by Logan. I don't know how he got that ball back, but it is.
Another player's leg. Good heads-up play to get it back and put it in the goal. We've got a timeout with 42 seconds left. We'll keep it right here. It's a 6-point Pikeville lead, 57-51, and Folks, want to remind you, stay tuned right after this one. About 20 minutes after this one's over will be the tip-off, as it'll be South Floyd and Paintsville in the nightcap, and the two winners will advance to the championship game here tomorrow night. Be live right here on Channel 5, tip-off at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. And after we wrap this one up too, Pete, we're going to try to get you down here and get some interviews prior to that next game, so be sure and stay tuned for that. See if we can get the Mr. Brent Rose on here.
Absolutely. Very good host. Here's helping us out considerably. Brent Rose, the principal at Betsy Layne High School. And we have only 42 seconds left, Ken. 6-point lead. But if they make some threes, you know, that's still a long game. A three-pointer makes the game a lot closer, doesn't it?
You look at that, it's just two possessions, two shots, and it's a tie game. But Pikeville has done a good job holding their own here in this fourth quarter.
Here's Honaker facing the pressure defense, full court. Jonah Justice, we got some kind of collision. I was looking at the ball out of bounds, and their collision with Bale. And
it'll be on Logan Bryant. Yeah, that'll be his third, and that's going to put Clavinger, I believe, back on the line.
Well, we couldn't see it. Maybe Wayne got it up there. Do you get that, Wayne? Wayne shakes his head. He got it. So our viewers saw it.
Oh, if it happens out there on this floor, they'll get it because Wayne Jugert's filming.
That's right. Good man on that camera. Here's Bales. First toss, a double bonus. He misses. Adams comes back into the game. He's going to stay down on the far end of the court for defensive purposes, guarding the basket.
Tyler Newsom back in for Shelby Valley.
Bale's second toss is good. 58-51. Here's Eliza Justice, front court. Tyler Newsom for three in the corner, missing. Honaker with the rebound, and he is fouled.
Good strong rebound down there by Tim Honaker. And Jacob Bryant picks up his fourth foul.
A lot of boys that do not have the strength of Honaker couldn't have got that rebound.
Right,
he is
strong,
strong
man.
Well, he had Jacob Bryant in there fighting for that rebound, too. And Jacob's a nice, strong kid, too.
Absolutely.
Here's Honaker. Double bonus coming up. First one is good. 36 seconds exactly to play in this very well-played, exciting basketball contest. Two good basketball teams. Honaker, second one is also good. 60-51, 36 seconds. Here's Elison, front court. Long three, 25-footer, short, and no good. Varney with the board. Out it goes to Jacob Bryant. Back to Varney. And the court, he loses out of bounds. Turnover. Unforced turnover by Shelby Valley at the wrong time of the game. 26 seconds to go. Honaker throws it high. Almost intercepted. I believe it was. Yes. That was Newsom on interception. He throws it to Jonah Justice. He misses a three. Ball's knocked out of bounds. And it will go to, what's a call?
Back to Pike, boys. Looks like the Panthers are going to pull it off here, Pete. 60-51 and only 19 seconds to play.
Here's Clevenger, double-teaming backcourt. Knocked out of his hands.
16 seconds now remaining. Big win here for Coach Bart Williams and the Panthers.
Certainly is. Run out. There's a run out. Long football pass down to Bale. Bale knocks it to the floor. Burchett picks it up. Pikeville pushed from behind by Newsom.
Tyler Newsom commits the foul. It'll be his first.
Well, you'd have to call it an upset with the team at Shelby Valley beat by 15.
Right.
And not a big upset, but anyway,
it's an
upset.
Burchett, it's the first one.
Not to take anything away from Pikeville. They're going to have to be contended with in the 15th region. There's no question about it. Coach Williams says his team is improving. They got quite a team here tonight. Not many ball clubs in the 15th could handle Pikeville. With 12 seconds to play, 62-51. We'll keep it right here if it's timeout. No, it's not a timeout. Here's Elisa Justice. Jacob Bryant, three-pointer on the way. It's no good. Rebounded by Adams. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. They're just holding backcourt. Bell lets the ball go to the floor, and that's the old ball game. Pikeville's pulled it off tonight. In the first round of the semifinal contest, they'll be playing in the championship game tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. We'll take the station, be back for final analysis and stats. This is your Intermountain Sports Network.
I've created a way to watch hit movies at home with complete control.
You're mad.
It's not madness. It's movies on demand. Just go to the on-screen guide with your remote and choose from hundreds of titles.
You got mad skills.
Start your movie whenever you desire. Even pause, rewind, or fast forward without a VCR. Movies on demand. Not evil, just genius.
What are people saying about Pikeville College? Pikeville College is about the students.
We have a small lab setting, so you really get to know the students and interact very well with the students.
I know every student's name. When a student asks me for help, I know who they are.
And the professors want you to succeed. Anytime you need help, all you have to do is stop by their office.
The professors are always available. They're there for you.
Pikeville College is changing our world, one graduate at a time. We would like to include you.
Johnson Industries Unisampler is a coal auger sampling system developed and manufactured by Johnson Industries. The Unisampler is a unique sampling system that will allow the operator to extract coal from trucks, rail cars, and river barges in as little as 30 seconds. No conveyor belts or shaker tables are required. No carousel is needed, and only one operator is required for the system. The Unisampler is being utilized by two of the largest coal laboratories in the world, Johnson Industries. Products developed by miners for miners.
Everyone's talking about it.
Wow.
Unbelievable. The best thing since cable.
Intermountain Cable saves you a bundle with four great services on one easy monthly statement.
That's fantastic.
Digital cable, high-speed internet, digital phone, and home security for one very low monthly price. Intermountain Cable gives you all the entertainment and security your home needs.
Wow, sign me up. I love it.
You guys are the best.
And welcome back here to Betsy Layne High School. The Pikeville Panthers over Shelby Valley, 62-51. And I'll tell you, big win for Coach Bart Williams and his Panthers here, Pete.
It certainly is a big lift for the program. Although we knew they were capable of winning any game in the region they play, they're coming along. They're improving every game. They got speed. They got the big guy inside, and they got Honaker, who can go inside or outside. A great scrapper. So they've got the ingredients for a really good high school basketball team. If they keep improving, they're going to be a force to be reckoned with in this region, no question about it.
Oh, no doubt about it. They've proven that tonight, and they're in the championship game tomorrow night, and they'll take on the winner of these two teams warming up out here. We'll be bringing you their game here in just a few minutes. It'll be Paintsville and South Floyd, but we want to go over the numbers in this first game as Pikeville 62-51. Running down your individual scoring, Elisa Justice finished tonight with 9 points for Shelby Valley. Wildcats led by Ashley Hatfield and Jonah Justice with 13 points each. Tyler Newsom off the bench with 6, and 5 points for Jacob Bryant, and 5 also for Logan Bryant to round out Shelby Valley scoring. Pikeville was led tonight by Tim Honaker with 15 points, Matt Clevenger 14, Devin Adams 13, and Jordan Bell with 10. Gatlin Clark had 8 and Devin Birch at 2, so our 4 of the 5 starters beat in double figures. Great balanced attack tonight by Pikeville. Rebounding, it was Shelby Valley 27-21 over Pikeville, and turnovers, Pikeville committed 15, Shelby Valley 12. But like I said, just a great balanced effort by the Panthers. Really spread the ball around, got good shots, and made good decisions, and a big win for them.
Very smart basketball, full court and half court. They moved the ball well. The playmaker, Clevenger, played a great game as usual, and I like the way he penetrates, and he leads that team. When he sees open space, he really goes for the basket. And then you have, you know, the start of that third quarter, you know, Clark hit those 2 threes. I thought that gave a spark to Pikeville. And then you got Adams playing a good game on the inside. And, well, the boys, the rest, Bell hustled. 4 players, double figures. What are you going to do with a team when they get a spark like that and they really hustle on offense and defense? And Shelby Valley wasn't on their game. Eliza Justice didn't have that great a ball game. And, you know, he's usually a really, really high scoring, good shooter. And they were off on their shooting night, the whole team. I thought Hatfield did really well for them. And of course, Jonah Justice did a great job.
Jonah, maybe the only one that really shot it consistently throughout the game for Shelby Valley. But like I said, they really struggled with their shooting tonight, and it cost them dearly. They ended up winning the battle on the boards, out rebounding Pikeville, and had fewer turnovers, but just didn't match them point wise. Just didn't make the shots, and it was quite a ball game, very exciting game. So both teams really got after it defensively.
Oh yes, they did. That first half for both defenses were really tough, but I think they got fired up. Both teams did coming out, and offensively they started moving the ball really well on offense. And especially Pikeville, and they got open shots. And they had that inside presence of Adams and Honaker when he wanted to go into the high post. Then they had some outside shooting and the penetration of Clevenger. They got the ingredients for a fine basketball team.
Yes, they have. And Pete Paintsville and South Floyd getting ready here. Boy, what a performance last night by the Paintsville Tigers here. They beat Allen Central by 11, had leads as big as, I think, 24 points or something. But Allen Central kept making those runs and coming back. It was an exciting game. You don't see a lot of games where the lead stays in double digits most of the night, but it was still very exciting. And Allen Central would make a quick 9-0 run and cut it to 11, and then Paintsville would blow back out by 20. But Landon Sloan, what a performer. He had 36 points last night for Paintsville, and he's just a tremendous basketball player. Got a great, great shooter. I made a comment today. I think the kid is as good an outside shooter as Chris Lofton was in high school, and he is. He just got tremendous range, can shoot it from all over the court, and he's a fun player to watch.
Thing about the land, he's not just a scorer, folks. He's an all-around ball player, good on defense. He hustles hard, and he's a team player.
He
got 36 points. He was open. They fed him. He made great moves. I watched a little bit of it last night in the second half. Made some great moves to the basket. He always shoots good on the move.
And I think from what I've been told, he's also leading the team in rebounding and assists, as well as being the top scorer. So, like I said, he's not just a shooter, not just a scorer. He's an all-around basketball player. And this very good Paintsville team, Coach Barry Hall's Raiders, have had a tough year. They're really struggling. They're playing a lot of young players and having a tough year, but it's going to be quite a challenge for them, but you never know what will happen.
No, they won the first game last night by a forfeit.
By
2-0.
Right.
I asked Harold Tackett over there, the AD at Baseline. I said, well, who gets credit for that 2 points? He said, huh, never thought of that. Might be Barry Hall might get 2 points.
Give those to Barry. There you go.
Give those to Barry Hall. So they got it by a forfeiture from the Pierce School over there at Martin, and we don't know the reasons why they didn't play, but they did. So that goes for forfeiture for this ball club. The South Florida, the first win, they got their work cut out for them, but they got a young ball club. They really have, and Coach Hall knows that he has to build for the future. I mean, he knows he's not going anywhere this year. But and, you know, you find a lot of ball clubs in the small schools like we have in Eastern Kentucky especially. They run out of material occasionally, and they have to rebuild. You have to bring your young players up, but he has a lot of young players that he can build around for the future.
Yes, he has. Well, Pete, that'll wrap us up for tonight's opening game, and congratulations to Coach Bart Williams and the Pikeville Panthers as they win it over Shelby Valley 62-51. So, folks, don't go anywhere. We'll be back in just a few minutes with more pregame activities and then the tip-off of Paintsville and South Floyd right here on Eastern Kentucky Sports Leader, the Intermountain Sports Network.